All right, got stuff today for the Genesis Mega Drive, of course, as always, but was a pretty decent turnout today. I mean, I got of the things. One of them is something I've been wanting to get for a while now, so I'm glad about that. I think it's missing its one flap, though, but who gives a crap? It'll still work. And the other thing I want to mention about this is I did say this before, but I might as well say it again because I really do think, especially after today, because I kind of went a little over and I used some of my, as I call it, the Neo Geo fund to get that 161 cartridge. I think I'm really going to start winding down what games I'm getting for this thing. There's probably like one or two others I want to get if I could find them. There's a couple accessories I want to get, namely the Justifier, the light gun for it. But mainly the only game I really want to get is Castlevania Bloodlines, which is going to really blow because I don't want to get that on eBay. I'm kind of, how else am I supposed to get it? It sucks. But anyway, so I'm going to show you this here, and one game's even sealed, but it's not, original factory seal, but still, it's really nice. Two of them are cardboard games, which is kind of odd. But anyway, first thing I'm going to show is this, because I thought this was really cool. One's missing because I got it in the refrigerator, but I thought they were going to do this because Coca-Cola did, but Pepsi's now got retro bottles now, too. Yes. Just like Coca-Cola did. And now Pepsi's got them, too. Ooh. Not that much either. So that's cool. I had to get them just so I have like at least one empty bottle I can keep along with the Coca-Cola ones because I just think it's cool. Of course, they're not real ones from the 50s, but whatever. Anyway, let's get started with this actual game stuff. There was two of these there. I got the one that was less dirty and in better condition. It's a lot easier to clean, which I haven't done that to any of these, which I'll do before I use them. So that's probably what I'm going to be doing for the rest of the time here is playing with all of these. But anyway, so I finally got this, and now, with the exception of Sonic Spinball, I now have all the Sonic stuff on the Genesis by itself. Not 32X and not Sega CD, but the Genesis itself. I still need Spinball, which is one of the other ones I mentioned. I did see that today, but it was too much and it was in bad condition, so hell no. I saw Star Fox Assault today too, but for $28, I'm not going for it. Anyway, I really don't feel like getting anything for the GameCube anymore. But here it is. Sonic and Knuckles, and I'm not using autofocus, so yeah. Now, I think if I'm right, the top flap is missing here, so who gives a crap, really? I mean, if I come across one that does have that, I'll probably get that one instead and, get rid of this one. But for now, this is good enough. I would like that it did have its flap. If you don't know, there's like this kind of flap that holds it on here, but it's kind of missing. You can see the pegs on where it belongs, but everything else is fine with it. Just needs to be cleaned up. Some of them won't be so dusty. So at least I finally have this, so that's good. Be kind of pointless if I didn't have Sonic 3, which I do, so there you go. This next one, this is now three of these. I'll be honest, I got them because they're not really that common. You don't really come across them that well. Unfortunately, some of these don't have their manual. One game I actually, one of the three that are kind of hard to come by, at one of the places I went to, I could have got it there cheaper, but just like here, it didn't have its manual or game, so whatever. I got it for what I got it for, but anyway. So here's one, and funny enough, someone was actually asking about this yesterday, last night, and more than likely he's going to see this video, so there you go. And like I told you, I do like this game. This is one I was playing on the emulator, believe it or not, and I actually was going to do a video on it, and I forgot what it was called, but there you go. Got the real one now. But it's Zany Golf, and yes, this is the one that's sealed. It's not a factory seal, like I said, back from the 90s, so whatever. And there you go. It's miniature golf, but it has all kinds of crazy stuff going on. And one of the things, I said it there, it looks like Disney Castle. That's kind of weird, but whatever. Here's another one, and this one I know is not one you come across that often. It's a little rough, but who cares? Unfortunately, this one doesn't have its manual, but it's fine. I'll live without it. Bonanza Brothers. Yes. Also, looks like their guns are flashlights, but anyway, yeah. This is an interesting one. I'll be doing a video on this one, definitely. And it's another grid box, which is cool. So there's that. This is another one I wasn't really sure about because I played a good amount of the pinball games on the Genesis Mega Drive, but I don't remember this one specifically. But again, just like the previous three, Zany Golf, Bonanza Brothers, and this isn't one that really comes across that often. I don't know. But it's Virtual Pinball, another Electronic Arts one. This one doesn't have its manual either. Like I said, I could have got this slightly cheaper, but it didn't have its manual either, so who cares? A lot of different tables and things. One cool thing, though, is well, all these EA cartridges have that yellow stripe and they're bigger and they don't cover the entire cartridge slot so dust can get in. But it's purple, which is not something I'd really expect. Of course, the best pinball game to play on it is Devil's Crush, but, or whatever. Now, this is one I don't really particularly like the game that much, but it's still good enough to play. It's friggin' hard to control. Usually, I see this in, like, the clam box, like this. Well, this is a little thicker because it's EA one, but you get my point. But this other game I'm going to show, the last one, actually was in a cardboard box there too, and I was trying to think, should I get it in the cardboard box or this one, even though it costs the same. But anyway, so I got this one. I've never seen it before in the cardboard box. I know you can get it in the cardboard box, and it's in good condition and actually has its manual and everything. But yeah, this game is not that hot. Unfortunately, two things are wrong with this. One, they wrote a fucking marker on here, so that's going to be a pain in the ass to get off of the cardboard box, but I do know how to do it. It's just slow and, you know, tedious. The other thing is there's a sticker on here, which I fucking hate stickers, and that is not what I paid for it. But anyway, combat cars. Yes. Like I said, I usually see this in the hard clamshell box, but this one's in cardboard, and it has its manual and it has the cartridge, so there you go. Really cool picture on the front, though. It's not, I don't know, it's not that good of a game, really, but it's average, passable, and there you go. But whatever. It's one of those ones you'll have more fun playing against a real player, basically. Now, here's one I've never played. I actually take that back. I did play it once, but it was so long ago, I pretty much forget about it anytime. I got a little bit to clean up on this one, too, but whatever. Like I said, I didn't get around to that yet. There's many different variations. In fact, I even mentioned once in one place I went to, there was a Metal Gear Solid version of this, and I never got it, which I'm kind of ashamed, but I don't have anyone to play it with. At least the video game version I could play against the computer. But I was thinking about getting this for quite a while, but I never really came across it that many times, and a few times I did, I didn't get it, but I got it now for really cheap. And I have no idea how good this works on it, but from what I was reading, it's a fairly decent, you know, video game adaptation. And that's Risk. Yes. The World of Conquest, and you can see up there what I paid for it, $3. Ooh. But anyway, I really like the picture on the front. It's a very nice drawn picture. And if you're familiar with Risk, you know what it's about, but it's kind of like a strategy conquest game. You can use cannons, so it's fun like that there. That and the arcade competition bullet kind of won me over. This one's got everything in it, though. Now, like I said, this is also one. This is the one I mentioned also that there was a cardboard box version, but I don't know if this one was the more common one or the cardboard box one was the more common one. Cost the same no matter which one it was, and it was in just as good condition and had the manual. But I went with the hard box because I like this better. I don't know. Kind of like combat cars. I see that a lot in the hard one, but whatever. Also, I want to point out you can play up this with up to 6 players, which of course means you need the multi-tap. Now, because it's been so long since I played the actual board game, I'm going to have to read how the fuck you play this shit. But that's pretty much it. If anything, I was a little disappointed that this doesn't have its flap, but I've been looking for this for a good amount of time now, so it's worth it to me just to get it like this. Like I said, I'll probably come across this sometime when it's in, got the flap and probably cleaner and all that, but it works, it'll be fine, because I just want to play it for now. I probably will try and actively find a better version of this, even if I pay a little bit more. This one wasn't that much, but, you know, at least I finally have it. So, that's it. Went a little long, but oh well. Major important thing today was get my damn hair cut. I was getting on my nerves. And then after that, all this. So, this was a pretty good turnout. So, I'm going to play Zany Golf now, because that game's ridiculous. But I'll be doing videos probably on each one of these. Risk probably take a little longer because I got to get used to it. But anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. I've done this, talk about this long enough. And I will see you sometime later.